This conference will now be recorded.
Guys, the workspace is like collections, 9 AM examples, I think. Yeah. So last class for the topic has been done. Last class, you can take the collections. Good. I think day one we discuss introduction part, right? Arrays versus collections, what exactly array, what exactly collections and all, and definition of the collection we discussed, and what are the topics we are going to cover in the collections, and list implementation example one, right? Example one is done, first class. Array list contains three constructors, right? Exactly. And auto boxing versus two string, first day we discussed. Second day we discussed about the collections are type safe or not type safe. Guys, that collections are type safe or not? Not type safe, right? How to make the type safe with the collections with the help of generics, right? Yeah, arrays are by default type, but collections are flexible with respect to memory and operations we done, and basic operations on array list. So set the data and all we done, and basic operations again we done, like today is day three notes, guys. If you go for day three once today, I said like array list contains how many constructors total? Three constructors, right? One is like default constructor. Second one is like default capacity is how much? Your default capacity is 10, right? Exactly. Yesterday example one about the third constructor. Third constructor is what? Adding one collection data into another collection, right? Exactly. This is like constructor three. So constructor is expecting like what? To add one collection data another collection, right? Exactly. See guys, array list a1 equal new array list of, array list a2 equal new array list of, I'm passing this a1 data into what? A2 constructor, right? A2, this is like constructor here. What we are passing here, a1 object we are passing, right? Guys, we are passing what? A1 object or not? Exactly. Because basically to add the one collection data into another collection, there are two ways to add the one collection data into another collection, guys. Guys, how many ways you can add one collection data into another collection? Total two ways are there, right? What are the two ways? One is a constructor approach, guys. Guys, one is what? A constructor approach. Okay. Last class, it is an example five. As you can go for today, we'll complete the array list, guys. We'll discuss some more examples at the array list. Today, we'll complete the array list. So click on new. I want to create the class array list example six. Array list example six. Okay, click on main method, guys. So just click on the finish. So array list example six class is generated. So here you can just right click and close all the files will be closed. Array list example six, here you can write the code, right? Exactly. Guys, what the point you can see, array list a1 contains like two objects. So a1.add of what? Array list you're making generic question, right? Generic question is what type of generic question you're making? String, right? So that we can add the array list, you can add which data, what type of data in the array list? String data, right? Exactly. You can make like Ratan and Anu, the first array list contains data, and the second array list I can add some data like A2, guys. A2 I'm adding Naresh. A2 I'm adding something like otherwise Rani here, and A2 dot add of what? Rani is there, and we can make like A2 dot add of what? Usman is there. Yeah, two values I'm making. Okay, C10, that A1 is there, right? For the A1, I'm passing A2 constructor, right? Yes, array list A2 is there. Array list A2 equal new array list of, I'm passing here what is the object here? A1 object, right? Exactly. Okay, this is the one way, this is like constructor approach, guys, because second constructor, array list constructor, what we are passing the data here? A1 object, right? Yes or no? This is like constructor approach, guys, adding one collection to another collection, right? This is like, constructor approach adding one collection into another collection, right? This is like constructor approach, guys. Nothing but simply we are adding this a1 into the a2 constructor, right? Yes, a2 contains a new array list of this. We are passing what? a1, right? Exactly. Because now if you print the sysout control space, so a2 I'm passing here. If you are passing a2 means then a2 contains total how many objects now? Guys, now a2 contains how many objects? Now
Oh.
A2 contains like four objects, right? Exactly. If you only can run this code, so you only can run this code, we got the output like total how many values, guys? Probably got the four values, right? Ratan, Hanu, Rani, and Osman is right. Exactly. Okay, this is the constructor approach, adding one collection data into another collection, right? Here, this A1 data you are passing to the A2 construct, right? Exactly. The second approach, constructor approach, guys. Next one is like add all method approach, right? Yeah, add all method also we can add one collection data into another collection, guys. Yes, add is used to add how many objects? Yes, add is used to add only one object, right? Exactly. Add is used to add only one object, guys. But what about add all method means array list what? Objects one, objects array one. So simply can take like obj1.add, obj1.add, right? Exactly. Okay, this is objects one dot. Can I make the generic question is what? Integer, right? Yes, you can't put like int here because wrapper collection supports only data, object data, right? That's what you can put the integer here, so that you can add one to which values, guys. So 10 is there, and here you can add the 20, right? Exactly. Okay, this is my objects one here. And you can make the objects two here. So this is even list. Even list contains even values, guys. 10, 20 is even values, right? So this is like even list. This is like even list. This is like even list. Otherwise, okay, fine. Objects one, you can take obj1, and objects two, you can make like this is object two, right? Object two dot add. Here I'm making like 100 and 200, guys. 100 and 200, right? Exactly. Yes, what is my question is like obj1 contains objects, one contains 10, 20, obj2 contains what? Obj2 contains what? Obj2 contains 100, 200, right? But my question is like I have the obj3. For the obj3, can I want add like obj1 data and obj2 data, objects one data and object two data? Then tell me how. Because constructor approach means what? Constructor approach is like is one-to-one approach, right? So one-to-one approach, guys. One-to-one means what? One collection data we can add into another collection, right? Only one-to-one possible. But what is my requirement here? Is one-to-one like many-to-one? This is like obj1, obj2. I want add into obj3, right? Because the statement is clear. Then what you can do? As don't say like sir, obj1 add into the obj2, obj2 is add into the obj3. Don't say like that, because assume like I have the three values are there, then adding first one into second one into third one into the fourth one, is it recommended or not recommended?
Okay.
Guys, is it recommended or not recommended? Definitely not recommended, right? Usman. Then what we will do, guys, in this case, to add the multiple collection data into another collection, guys, then you can go for the obj's dot add all method we have to use. obj's 3 dot what? We can use add all method, guys. Add all of what? Obj1. So obj's t dot add all of what? Obj2, right? Exactly. Yes. What are the difference between the add and add all method? See,
add
obj t dot add we can do. Add is used to add the only one object, guys. Assume like I'm adding 1000 here. As I'm adding 1000 here. So add is used to add the normal one object. What about add all? Add all is used to add the one object or collection data. Yes, add all is used to add what? One object or collection data?
Collection data,
right? Exactly. Usman, are you clear? Constructor approach means what we are doing is we are passing A1 object into the A2 constructor, right? One to one only possible. But here, what is my requirement here? Adding one collection, many collections. So many collections into another collection, right? Yeah, another collection. Many collection to one collection is what? This is like the concept like what? Many to one, right? Many to one. Then we can add these many collections into another collection, guys. You can go for what? Add all, right? So we got the difference between the add all and add method. Add is used to add what? Only one object, right? What about add all method, guys? Add all is used to add the multiple objects, right? Exactly, guys. This is our control space obj's 3, right? Exactly. Guys, obj's.3, right? Yeah, that is the information, guys. Is it clear now? Guys, now obj's 3 contains total how many elements? Yes, obj's 3 contains how many elements total?
Four.
obj's 3 contains how many elements means like total four elements, five elements?
Five elements.
Total five, right? Because OBJ is one contest, two
thousand.
element, like 1,000 also, right? So so the output is what? 10, 20, 100, 200, 1,000, right? Because the output is what? 10, 20, 10, 20, 1,000, 100, 200, 1,000, right? Exactly. Guys, tell me then how many ways you can add one collection data and another collection there are? Guys, how many ways you can add one collection data and another collection? There are two ways, right? What are the two ways, guys? One is like a constructor approach. Second one is what? Add all method, right? There are two ways to add one collection data and another collection, guys. One is like by using constructor approach. Constructor approach means what? Only one to one approach, right? So by using add all method means what? Many to one approach, right? That is like many to one approach or not. Exactly. Guys, there's an example one for today class, and we discuss the add versus add all. Add is used to add only one object. Add all is used to add what? Collection data, right? Add all is used to add what? Collection data, right? That's example one, guys. Guys, example one is clearer. Good. Guys, collections, we have the more and more examples, guys. I think last two class and today class also, every example definitely important, right? Guys, if any example you feel is not important, let me know so that I can remove that example from the topic.
No, sir.
Usman never tell, I know that. Okay.
But how we know, sir? But how we know?
No, you feel like very simple example like that, right? If anyone feel like very simple example we don't want, means I can remove. That's what.
But we need more example only.
Very good. Guys, here, you know, like employee class, right? Yesterday class, employee class is there. Here, how many employee updates I created total?
Four.
Guess total how many employee updates? Guess you respond, because every time again I'm
four.
Again, I'm creating update is recommended or not recommended. Employee one equal new employee is not required, right? Yeah. Yeah, good. So here array list one contains how many employee objects? Yes, array list one contains how many? Array list one, A1. A1 contains how
two.
Many objects?
Two
objects, right? Exactly. A1 contains two objects, guys. Now here I'm using like constructor approach. I can use add all also, right? It's not a problem. Now A2 contains how many objects now? Yes, now A2 contains how many objects? A2 dot add all of A1 means A1 complete data I'm adding into A2, right? A2 dot add all of A1 and E3 object and what? E4 object also, right? Exactly. Totally it contains how many objects, guys? Four objects,
four.
Right? Exactly. Yes, out of four objects, can you please tell the SOP of these two lines output? A2 dot A2 contains E1 object or not? Is that A2 contains E1 object or not? Does A2 contains
sir.
E1 object or not? Contains
yes,
to
sir,
check.
It contains.
Contains is used to check one object existed or not exist, right? Yeah. If you place the cursor in the contain, returns the true if returns true if the list contains a specified element. Yes or no? List contains specified element, right? Exactly. So it contains. What are the contains all? It contains one element. Contains a list. Returns the true if the this collection contains of all elements of specified collection. Difference between contains versus contains all is what, guys? Contains is used to check the one element. Contains all is used to check the one element or all elements. Returns true if the collection if this collection contains all elements of the specified collection, right? Guys, can I copy this line? This is information about what contains all, right? Yeah, this is like returns are true if the collection contains all. But this is like which method, guys? Here. Contains are contains all.
Contains all.
Yeah. What about contains method? Even I can copy this theory from material like ABA documentation itself. You can place the cursor in the contains method. It returns true. Returns true if the list contains the specified element or specified all elements are.
Specified elements.
Returns true if the list contains what a specified element. List contains the specified element, right? Returns true if second one is what contains all. Contains all returns true if the collection contains what all elements in the specified collection, right? Yes, one element, all elements. You can go with all elements, right? Exactly, guys. Yeah, that's what these two lines returns true or false now. Guys, these two lines are returns true or false. These two lines returns what? Tell me, yeah, these two lines returns true or both lines are returns are true, right? Exactly. That's what you got to operate true and true. Guys, I'm doing one small operation, remove operation, guys. Remove of even object, I'm removing. Remove of even object. After removing even object, can you please try these two lines again? Now tell me. Now what is output? A2 contains even object or not? I think you removed even object, right? A2 contains all of even objects or not? Is A2 contains all of even objects or not?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Because no. A1 one object is removed, right? Even object is removed, right? That's what A2 contains even means even single object is removed. Contains all means what? It is checking one element is all elements. All elements, right? But all elements are available, one element is removed from that. One element is removed, right? Like that. Because if you want, you can print the remaining element using for each loop. Right hand side, what? A2 object. Left hand side, A2 contains what type of data now? A2 contains definitely
employee data.
Employee. A2 contains employee data. Sysout control space, E.EID plus a space plus what? E.ename, right? That's it. Okay, so how many objects will be printed now? Remaining three objects, I think one is removed means 222, 333, triple.
Yeah, so what happened? A2. You took 8A1.
We have to take, right? Yeah. Good. If you run this code, then how many elements are there? 222, 333. Yeah, three elements are there. One element is removed, right? Exactly. Guys, first two lines, you get that true is output, true. Next two lines output is a false. And this example is also important, right? Contains all, guys. Contains used to check the even single line. I can explain, but if you write the example, it'll be better, right? Clearly understood, right? Yeah. So contains used to check the contains used to check what? One element or multiple element? Single element, right? Contains all to return what? True if the collection contains all elements in the specified collection, right? All elements it will check, guys. There's example number two. Good. Guys, example three we can do example three, what we will do, remove all versus retain all. Okay, guess example three, what we will do, remove all versus what? Retain all. Yeah, first example, what the point we discuss, add versus add all, right? Add versus add all. Second example discussed about the contains versus what? Contains all. Third example, what we'll discuss about remove versus remove all. Remove versus what? Remove all, right? Here I can do list contains this object, and here I don't want object creations process and all. So here I can do directly, you can do like this, right? Yes, now A1 contains how many objects now? A1 contains two objects. Here A1 constructor I'm passing here, A2 constructor I'm passing A1 here. I don't want add all method, but you understood, right? Two approaches. It's fine.
Yes.
So I can remove here, I can place the data. Here I can remove, I can place the data here, right? Exactly. Yes, now A1 contains how many objects now?
Two.
Yes, A1 contains how many objects? Two objects. A2 contains how many objects?
Four
objects, right? Exactly. Okay, see, I do not remove method, right? Remove method is used to remove how many objects? Remove is used to what? One object, right? Yes, I can do A2 dot remove all I can use. A2 dot removal of what? A1. Yes, from A2, then how many objects are removed?
Two objects
are removed.
Two objects removed means then what is the output you'll get now?
Two
removal objects. Of A1 means what? I think A1 data is removed, right? A1 data is removed means we got the output is what? 3344, right? 333444, right? Yeah. Yes, sir. No, we got the output is what? 333444. Yes, removal is used to remove what? Complete collection data, right? Exactly. Okay, so retain all is there. We try to understand the retain all once. So in place of remove all, can I write the code like retain all? Retain all. Retain all of A1. Guys, remove all means all which objects are removed? All A1 objects are removed, right?
Yes.
Yes, remove all means all A1 objects removed. Retain all means what? All A2 objects are removed except A1. Okay, the statement is clear. Remove all means all A1 is removed, guys. Retain all means what? Except A1, all A2 objects are removed. guys, the difference between removal and retain is clear. Removal means what?
Yes.
All A1 objects are removed. Retain all means what? Except this A1 object, except this A1 objects, remaining A2 objects are removed, right? Exactly, guys. Guys, now what is output now?
Sir, can we come back again on this retain?
No, removal means all A1 objects are removed, right?
Yes.
Retain all means all A2 objects are removed except A1.
So can you go? I mean, can you mark this as a comment? Retain all.
This one comment, huh?
Yes, yes. And again, uncomment the first one. Can you show the result, sir? Output. 333 Aruna Anu. Removal of A1.
A1 objects are removed, right? Are yaar, why you are thinking that much? See, A2 dot remove of E1 means which object removed? E1 is removed, right? Simply. E1 is removed. Removal of A1 means what happened? Complete A1 objects are removed here. Complete A1 objects are removed means what? A1 objects are what? Triple one, triple two, right? Triple one, triple two is removed. Triple one, triple two removed means what are the remaining values? 333, 444 is there, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So removal means all A1 objects are removed, right hand side data. Retain all means all A2 objects are removed now.
Okay, okay,
except
sir.
A1, except A1.
Okay.
Because
now,
A2
sir, can
show that, sir? Now this case, what's the output will get now?
In this
triple
case,
one, triple two.
Yes, 111, 222. Because it will retain only except A1, it will delete all the data. I mean,
exactly.
Remove all the data.
Exactly. Now this case, what's output now?
In this case,
the output
zero output,
nothing.
No output,
nothing.
No, Usman.
No output.
While he is speaking, in this case, meanwhile he is thinking.
Yes, while speaking, I am thinking. In this case, yes.
That is a talented case in the real time, guys. While speaking only, they will think what they have to tell in the next word. Managers. This trick will use by managers, honestly.
And by the end of my sentence, Guru said nothing, and I also said nothing.
No. Other guys said like immediately they are saying answer, something like that. But experienced guys never said answer immediately. So they said like you will remove, that A1 is removed. Yeah, fine. Vidya? What is the answer there in this case?
So I think exceptions.
Standpoint.
Exception.
Exception. With your breakfast complete,
huh? Why,
yes,
sir?
You are saying
yes,
exception.
Sir.
Why exception?
Because, sir, there is no data.
There is no data means
first
no output, right?
Then zero outputs, no outputs.
Why exception? There is no output, right? If you want to, at last you can write the print statement. Operations are what? String operation is completed. Operations are completed. If you run this code, there is no output because remove all means what? All A1 objects are removed. Retain all means what? All A2 objects are removed. Then what happened? This was empty, right? Is it clear now? That's called operations are what? Operations are completed. Guys, are you clear now? That's called removal versus what? Retain all, guys. Removal means what? All A1 objects are removed. Retain all means what? All A2 objects are removed. Except what? Except? Except. Except?
A1. Except A1.
Except A1, huh? Okay, fine. Guys, we understood like remove, what the difference between remove and removal? Today we discuss remove versus removal, add versus add all, contains versus contain all. These are examples, right? Exactly. Here you can do like this. This is a statement. Here it will remove all which data, guys, all A1 objects, right? Exactly. What about second case? Tell me. Retire all means what? Here it will remove all A2 objects except what? Except. Except what? Except A1, right? Exactly. Yeah. Except A1, right? Exactly. Is it clear now this example? Yeah, because today first example is what? Adding one collection data into another collection. Adding one collection data into what? Adding one collection data into another collection, first example. And second example discussed about the what second example is contains versus contains all. Contains versus contains all. And example three, what we discussed, remove versus remove all. Remove versus remove all and retain all else, right? Okay, this example we discussed about remove all versus retain all. Remove means what? Removes one element. Remove also means remove the complete element. Retain all means what? Removes all elements, right? Retain all also. So if you want just to place the cursor, remove all, removes or remove from this list all it's specified in the contained in the specified collection. This is the information from API documentation. Can I copy this code? It's like
yes,
remove all is there. Okay, next one is what? Retain all. Just place the cursor. Retains only the elements in the list that contain the specified collection. In other words, removes from this list of all elements that not contain the specified collection. Very good English.
Sir, it's better. Yes. you mention only the first line.
But students, they'll not understand what the retains, right? That's what, if you make the two lines, they may be better, right? They can read whatever they understood.
Well, I think every guy who is working in a company knows what retains means. Someone resigns, the company starts retaining them.
Okay. Yeah, so removal versus retain always. Removal means what? Removes from the list of all elements contains specified collection, right? Contains specified collection means what are the collection you specify, the data will be completely removed, right? Yeah, A1 data is completely removed. Retain means what? Retain only the elements in the list. Retain only the elements in the list contain the specified collection. In other words, removes the list.
So you are not audible.
Sir, not audible.
Sir, your screen seems hanged.
Hope network issue.
Looks network issue.
Yes, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I think network disconnected.
Yes, sir.
Cool. Please mute. Example 1, 2, 3, 4.
Example sir, your screen is freezed.
Now?
Cursor is before removes all, retain all that. I mean, yes. You're not able to see yours. I mean, we are able to see your screen, but it is hanged.
Now?
Now they are able to see your screen.
Yeah, good. Yes, example 3 done. Example 4, we'll take the two conversion processes. Yeah, check this conversion process once. Because before the collections, what we are using to store represent the group of elements. Before the collections to represent the group of elements, arrays we are using, right?
Arrays.
Exactly. Yes, before the collections to represent the group of elements, we are using like arrays concept. That's what assume like the previous project, guys. In my previous project, I'm using arrays. In my previous project, I'm using arrays. Later, I decided to use the collection. If later I decided to use the collection, means what I can do? Can I remove the complete arrays? Can I take the collection? Otherwise, simply convert that existing arrays into the collection format.
We can convert.
Is better. We can convert the existing collection into which format? Existing arrays into which format? Collection format, right? Exactly. Because to convert the existing arrays into the collection format, see guys here. So I have the previously string arrays in my project. To store the group of objects, I'm taking the string array, right? Now string array contains how many elements now? String array contains how many elements? Is it like return unwanted? Three elements, right? I decided to convert this into the array list format, guys. That's what. Can I take the array list? Array list of string data. I can take array list string of what? Objs of what? Objects of what? New array list of. You can take the version like string version, right? Exactly. Because here to this constructor, I have to pass this data, right? That's what, guys. To convert these arrays into the collection format, to convert these arrays into which format, guys? Collection format. We have like the class like arrays class is there. For the class name, guys. Here, arrays dot arrays class contains one method like as list method, guys. Arrays is a class. Arrays is a class belongs to util package. Arrays dot as list format you want to convert. Which array you want to convert the list format? Yes, right.
String. Yes.
Yes, right. String means like this is str. Is in like string array str. Just I can pass the str here, right? Like that, guys. So to this array list constructor, what we are passing? Arrays dot. Arrays dot what? Arrays dot as list method I'm passing, right? Exactly. Because even you can add the your objects also. Even you can add the array list dot add of objects dot add of. You can add the something like triple A here, something like you can add like some triple B, some different objects I'm adding, right? Yes, now your array list contains total how many objects now? Yes, now your array list contains how many objects now? This is our control.
Five objects.
So five objects, right? See the output, guys, now? Yeah, so Ratana Anu Sravya. So that is coming from the string array. Then we are converting the triple A triple B, right? There you are converting in what triple A and what triple B, right? Exactly. Okay, this is like conversion of what arrays to arrays to what? Arrays to collections, right?
Collections.
Exactly. Guys, I need the reverse process also. Maybe my project I'm using collections. I decided to some performance issues. I want to convert the arrays format. Even you can convert the what second conversion, guys, tell me. Collections to reverse, guys. Collections to arrays format. Right? Yes, this possibility also there, definitely. So arrays to collections, guys, this one is clear, right? Conversion of arrays to collections.
Yes, sir.
Arrays to collection means to this array list constructor, arrays dot as list method we can use. As list method is expecting argument like what the data we are passing here is to array. You can give that array, right? Exactly. Guys, next one is a collections to arrays. Collections to arrays means, see, for example, I have the array list something like A1 is there. Array list A1 is there. New array list of string version. Then a1.add is there, a1.add is right. a1.add. So Sravya, Anu, Sravya, and what? Ratan, right? Exactly. These three values are there. Because I want to convert this array list to the array format. Then tell me the procedure. Because this array list contains what type of data, no? Guys, this array list contains what type of data?
Collection.
String data.
String data. Collection only string data is correct. It means I can convert what type of array now? Definitely, it contains string data means. String what data. Type of array?
String type of array.
String array.
String type.
Sir, you are not audible.
Went into mute. Might have received some calls.
Yes, can you hear me? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Array list. Yeah, array list. See, I can convert what type of array basically, tell me now. We can convert what type of array?
String type of array.
Yeah, string array first. Let me create, right? String array s equal to. String array s equal to what? We can make the new string array. How much size of array have to create?
Three,
sir.
Three means like hard coding that value is recommended or not recommended?
Not recommended.
Then what you can do?
Leave it blank. No, sir, you can pass the collection. I mean, collection object in this?
A1. We can't do the like the type.
The answer is not audible.
Tell me here. See, array, what I'm saying, what type of array size, how much? Definitely we can create the string array because my array list contains string data, so that we have to create a string array only. How much is size? Here, definitely here we have to do the size, right? How much size means 3, but 3 is a hard to coded value, right? Maybe A1 later. Dot A1 dot not length, the size function is right. Guys, are you clear now? Size, right? I can use size, right? Exactly. Guys, now what I have to do? My array list is ready. My string array ready. That much length is there. Now, simply what I can do now? I have to convert this array list into array format, right? Then array list into array format means the name itself saying like, the method name itself saying like A1 dot, A1 is which data, guys? Collection data. A1 dot, what I can do? A1 dot to array format I have to convert, right? Yes or no? A1 is the collection data. A1 to 2 array format. The name itself like 2 array format, right? 2 array I can use. A1 to which array I have to convert? S array, right? Okay, the name itself is saying like A1 is a collection data contains. To store this collection data into the collection array format, string array we create because this is a type is a string. That's what you are creating, string type. Okay. How much length means 3, but don't make the 3 value here. Don't hard code the value. Size, maybe at runtime there is a 1000 elements also, they'll reflect it, right? It's not a problem. Then A1 is a collection data. A1 to array, to which array? String array, right? Exactly, guys. Sorry, clear now? Then you can print the data using S. S is like a string SS, right? Because S is a string, array. Just I'm printing the string array data, right? Exactly. Sysout control space, sysout control space. Just you can print what? SS, right? That's all, guys.
So you have converted and copied the conversion into the string S.
I didn't convert it here, right?
You have created an array, right? In the first step. In the second step, A1.2 array S. So now what you have done here? I mean, what this statement is actually doing?
What is that English word is saying? Two array means what?
Two array. Okay. If I, A1. For example, if so, okay, sir. If I for each loop, if I this, I mean, if I do this loop for A1, will the output be same in that case also?
Output is same, right? Because A1 contains, why A1 loop here? Yeah, A1 contains definitely 3 elements. Those A1 data to array we are converting. To which array we are converting? To S. String array. It means you're copying your A values into which format? String array format, right?
And so can we assign this whole sentence to some other array? Let's take some other array, sir. I mean S1. Take S1 array.
S1 array is there, okay, fine.
And A1.2 array
to S1
equal to assign this value A1.2 array S to S1.
That case, two array method return type should be the array type, right? Because here, if you're making S1 here, as per your knowledge, then this is you immediately have to think like two array method has to return the array, right? But if you make the two array return type is what, it will be maybe void. Cannot convert the string array to the S1 array format, right? Yeah, see right hand side you are making the variable means make sure that your method, this method has to return that array, right? But is that method is returning the array? Is that method is expecting just a conversion process?
Okay. This method is not returning an array. Else we would have been able to do it, okay.
Exactly. This is like conversion process, guys. What we do, this is like conversion of what, string array to array list to what, string array format, right? Exactly, guys. This is like normal version of collection, generic version of collection. We got output like
generic version of collection, sir.
This is like which version of collection? Normal version, generic version of collection to arrays, right? Generic question means contains what type of data? Similar type of data, different types of data? Similar type of data means can I create the string array directly? Then it will be fine, right? Exactly. But if you take the before generic version, what the version we have? Normal version of collection, right? So now guys, normal version collections to array format. Yes, normal version means what? Then my array list obj's new array list of this is like normal version, generic version.
Normal version, sir.
Yeah, array list data equal new array list of data dot add of. Can I add 10 here? Array list data data, yeah, data dot add of. Can we add the Ratal here? Is any problem here? This is normal version of collection, sir. Generic version of collection. This is like
normal version, sir.
Yeah, exactly. If it is normal version of the collection, then I want to convert this normal version of the collection to which format, guys? I want to convert this normal version of the collection to array format, right? Then how? If this two array method, this one will work. It won't, right? Because it is it this two array method expecting the argument like string array. We expect in the array argument. Previously we know that array list contains only string data. I can create a string array. But here, do you have any specific data? Different types of data?
We have different type of data.
Then why can't create like string array, integer array, float array, right? Is it clear now? Yes, definitely normal version is not recommended. In Eclipse IDE, when you write the code with normal version, is always saying bulb symbol, guys. Make sure that if your code is saying bulb symbol means your code is valid, but it won't accept in the real time. It won't accept in the application level. In application level, the code should be clean. In IDE, whatever the code you written, that should be clean. Yeah, that statement is clear. Whatever the code we written, that should be the clean, right? That should be the clean, guys. Is that clear now? Array list data equal new array list of, this is the data, add of 10, add of Ratan, add of 10.5 is there. Yeah, that is information, right? But guys, then what we can do, like, you know, data dot, we have under two arrays overload method, guys. Two arrays overload method means what? This you can see the two methods, guys. So two arrays like overload method, one is like without argument, second is with argument, right? I think previously we done the two array with argument, right? It is string argument you are passing. Now we can use a two array without argument, guys. So without argument means what happened, you know, data dot two array, which is converting return type is what, you know, object array, guys. Because this one is contains one type of data, different types of data. Returning an array containing all elements in the list, right? In proper sequence format. Yes, yes or no? Yes. If you know the type means, you can create the type of the data directly, can pass the two array to the type actually. Directly it is possible, right? Guys, two array to the type you can pass, right? But here, do you know like two array of which type you can convert here? Which type? String means str type, float means float type. Do you know like which type you have to convert? No, right? That's what you don't pass any argument. Guys, only simple thing, guys. If you know the type means, you can create that array type, just you are passing that argument here, that will be fine. Application is done. But here, do you know like which type it written? Which type it is taking? No, right? Because it contains different data. That's what data dot two array. Then you can take what? The return type of this one is what? Object array. Because object array can hold any type of objects, right? That's what, guys. Can print the data using for each loop, guys. Wo contains one type of data, different types of data.
Different type of data.
Yes, previously string array means right hand side I can make the S. Left hand side string type is there, but here object array. Object array means what? O contains different types of data, right? So that I can hold the object over, right? Exactly, guys. Object over. The sysout control space what? Over is there, right? Exactly. Guys, are it clear now? Yeah. So total two array methods. Total how many methods are there total? There are two array methods. If we know the argument, if you know the type of the data, create that array type, pass the argument here directly, that will be fine. If you don't know the argument means what? If you don't know the type of the data, what we have to create, guys, we don't know what type of you have to create, then what we have to do here? Two array of what? Without argument you can take. Without argument means what happened, guys? Object array written, you can depend that object array. Guys, are you clear now? two array
Yes,
total,
sir.
how many methods? Total two methods, right? So second case also we got output like what? This is the first one output, guys. This is the second one output. This is the third one output, right? Exactly. Okay. This conversion process, guys, arrays to collections, collections to what? Arrays, right? This is the first case. Just I'm making some stars here. This is the second case. I'm making some stars here. Last case, I'm making some stars, right? Exactly. Guys, if you see the collection example, all example, whatever the code I written, do you find any bulb symbols?
No.
Except normal version.
Yes, sir.
When you write
yes.
the code normal version, definitely we can get the bulb symbol. That we can't do anything.
What
so
we is
can
bulb
says? Bulb says like warning.
Okay.
It's saying like multiple markers at this line, a list of raw type reference should be something like this. It's like warning. So we should take care about the warnings also. Even warning also not acceptable in application level. Warning is there means something is better is there.
Okay.
Yes, the statement is clear. Warning is there means something is better is there.
Means then we have code can be optimized.
Code can be optimized, exactly. Yeah, this is like example four, what we done like conversion process, right? Arrays to collections, collections to arrays. We done the two methods. We have the overload method, right? Two arrays like the overload method, guys. Arrays to collections means as list method you can use. Collections to arrays format means what? Two array. Two array, how many two array methods are there? Two array, we have like two methods are there. Two array with argument is there. With argument means what, guys? This is normal version of collection, the generic version of collection.
Generic
version. With argument means you know the type. Yeah, you know the type means what? This is like a generic version of collection to generic version of. Tell me, guys, this is like generic version of collection to array format, right? Exactly. Because two array without argument is there, right? Two array without argument. Without argument means we don't know the type, right? We don't know the type means we can't do anything. That's what this is like, what? Normal version of collection, right? Exactly. Guys, this is something like, okay, normal version of, tell me, guys, normal version of collection to which format here? Array format, right? Exactly. Guys, conversion process, guys, this is example we done like two conversions here. Normal version of arrays to collection, generic version of arrays to collection, right? Exactly. Yeah, otherwise I can keep the starting itself. Guess theory placing the starting is recommended, after the exam is recommended theory points. Before example you have to place, right? Better.
Yes, sir. Before example.
Before example I have to place. You understood this theory, then you can take the data, right? Yeah, remove all data. Fine, guys. This is example four. Yes, today we done how many examples? Total we done like how many examples? Guys, how many examples? Total we done like four examples, right? But the first example, guys, add versus
add versus add all,
remove versus what? Second example,
retain all, remove
add versus add all. Second example, contains versus contains all, right? Contains versus what? Contains all. Third example, retain all versus remove all, something like that, right? Fourth example,
contains all. Which example, sir?
Second example, contain and contain all.
Okay.
Second example versus contain versus contain all. Third example, retain versus retain all. So remove all versus retain all. Remove all versus retain all. Fourth example is what? Conversion process, right?
Conversion.
Yes, total
process.
We done how many examples total? Yeah,
four
examples, right? Exactly. These are clear. Any questions?
Questions? No.
So day two, type safety processing, you're discussing how to provide the type safety here. And yesterday one guys asked one question, guys, regarding this yesterday example, last class example. See what the question, you know, the small, very small question. Yesterday example we are doing like basic operation in the array list, right? Example four, you can see, guys, here removal, what it will do? Guys, removal, what it will do? So remove method, what it will do? Guys, the remove method, if you remove the data from the collection, remove method, how many ways you can remove? Either you can pass the object or you can pass the index, right? Yes, you can pass the object or you can pass what index also, right? Exactly.
Yes.
You see, for example, array list of I'm passing these two elements here. Array list of two elements we are passing here. Yeah. Here you can pass the array list of two elements, right? Exactly. Guys, I can add one more element, like you can make it like Ratan here, because I want to remove the Ratan. So to remove the Ratan, simply what it will do? So al dot remove of, you can give the object, right? What is the object, guys? Here Ratan. Because I want to remove the 10. This is out control space. I'm printing al here. So you can just print the run this code. Guys, what is the output now? We'll get 10 and 10.5, right? Because remove Ratan is remove, right? Exactly. Because I want to remove the 10. If you decide to remove the 10, if you are passing remove of 10, means what happened, guys? Do you think 10 is taken as object format, index format?
Index format.
But your requirement is remove the 10 here. But this is 10 is the object or index? 10 is object index. Or index? Index, right? If you pass like this, guys, definitely we got exception. Like which exception? Index out of bounds exception, guys. Yes, we got output is what? Index out of bounds exception. Index is what, guys? 10, but size how much here? 2, right? Guys, that's what, if you want to remove this kind of data, we should take care about the indexing, okay? We should take care about indexing.
So in this case, we will have to pass the index, sir?
Integer value, if you are passing, by default, it is taken as index. But maybe if you are thinking like, sir, I have the 10, I want to remove the 10, means it's not allowed. We have to check and we have to remove the data properly.
Okay.
Your requirement is a 10 you want to remove. You are passing remove of 10, but remove of 10 is by default taking what type of data? Remove of 10 means it is taking by default index, right? Yeah, remove method, if you are passing the integer value, by default it is taking what? Index.
So that is Ratan sir, if I pass 10.5, then it can remove 10.5 in that case.
Index only in the integer format, right? 10.5 is not an index, right?
Yes.
Index exactly. From 0, 1, 2. You got output is only 10. It's not a point. 10 means what? Index based. Integer number, it can take the index format.
Okay.
In the basic operation array list, I guess, yesterday class, here you can make the small observation. So, observation example. This end can do, right? Remove of 10 means what? Maybe you're thinking like you want to remove the 10, but it is taken as index format. We got the exception like what? Index out of bounds exception, right? Exactly. Is any questions?
No, sir.
Yeah, that's all examples, guys. So we're done with the day 3. So we'll meet in tomorrow. What's the time now?
10:10.
Tomorrow we'll meet, guys. Bye. I'll share this note. You try to check the notes. We'll meet in tomorrow. We'll continue. Bye.
Thank you, sir.